budget while respecting your time.
With 20 convenient locations, we're the one-stop destination for all your automotive needs.
At Boucher, we're your trusted partner on every mile of your journey. Riding with you every mile since 1977.
Hi, John McGivern here. Did you know Network Health has Medicare Advantage plans that give you $25 a month back towards your Medicare Part B premium? That's $300 a year back in your pocket. Isn't that great? Call 833-7-NETWORK to learn more today. Network Health Medicare Advantage plans include PPO plans with a Medicare contract. Enrollment in Network Health Medicare Advantage plans depends on contract renewal. Certain restrictions apply to the Part B giveback. Visit networkhealth.com/Medicare/extra benefits for details.
Covering the crew all season long on WTMJ, it's Brewers Extra Innings. Now live from the Annex Wealth Management Studios in downtown Milwaukee at The Avenue, here is your host, Dominic Cotroneo.
How does the best record in the National League sound? It's April. We're not going to get ahead of ourselves here, but the Brewers win 11-1. Game one of the three-game set in Baltimore, taking on the Orioles, and it was all Brewers early. Freddy Peralta turned in his best start of the young season. He continues his hot stretch. I've got some mind-blowing numbers to complement that. Willy Adames had himself a day. He almost had a two-homer game again. William Contreras hit another bomb. Joey Ortiz got some revenge on his old team. And D.L. Hall will try to do the same tomorrow. Through the wind and the rain, and I blame Lane Grindle. If you were listening, Lane Grindle said, oh, it's been a beautiful day for baseball. Then, bam, it started raining. And it didn't stop raining the rest of the game. So that's on you, Lane. There was rain in the forecast. I don't know what forecast those guys looked at. They looked at the wrong model, I guess. I was ready on rain delay alert just in case. But nonetheless, we got it in. Let's go ahead and jump to the most pressing thing of the day before I get into the three most important plays. Christian Yelich exited this game with what was described as lower back tightness after just one inning of play today. He got a base hit, then the next inning he wasn't out there on defense. The word from Kurt Hogue, who is on the ground in Baltimore from the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel, from Pat Murphy, says, confirming that it is lower back tightness. They will reevaluate tomorrow, nothing further. So this could be a variety of things. We've seen this before from Yelly. It's not the neck again, it's the lower back, and we know the back has been an issue for him for the last couple of years. I'm not going to overreact until there's a reason to overreact. That being said, to still throw up 11 runs today, that's five straight games that they've scored at least seven runs in. First time they've done that since 2021. And that was a pretty darn good offense. There are guys ready to pick up the slack right now for this team. 855-616-1620. Again, 855-616-1620. I'm flying solo tonight. We'll be having Jerry Augustine join us throughout the weekend, but just not tonight. So I'd love to hear from you, the fans, tonight. Again, the phone number, 855-616-1620. 855-616-1620. Or you can tweet me, at @Dom_Cotroneo, C-O-T-R-O-N-E-O, Cotroneo. This text here from Josh in Milwaukee. I've been really impressed by the offensive approach early in the season. The at-bats are patient. Base runners and hits have come in a multitude of ways, and situational hitting has been productive. It's also clear that the veteran leadership brings an edge to this team. Fingers crossed that Yelly will be all right. When it comes to the situational hitting, 5 for 12 with runners in scoring position tonight, including three home runs. 5 for 12, nearly 500 again with runners in scoring position. So they actually improved their baseball leading stat with runners in scoring position. So including tonight's game, the Brewers are now hitting .377 with runners in scoring position. That leads baseball. And if you listen to me all of last season, you hear me talk about this number a lot and how many opportunities they're getting with runners in scoring position. They've had 114 at-bats, but obviously that doesn't include sack flies, hit by pitches, or things of that nature. When we look at plate appearances, right? The Brewers have had 132 plate appearances with runners in scoring position, which is above league average. It's the top half of the pack. Last year, for the majority of the year, if not all of the year, they were dead last in total plate appearances with runners in scoring position. Because when you looked at the rate stats, you're thinking, well, it's not that bad. They're right around league average. And then you realize how few opportunities they were giving themselves. And you see it now. They're giving themselves opportunity. Cool, they scored three. They hit three home runs today. That's great. They didn't need all three homers to score 11 runs. They're showing a variety of ways to get the job done. And it certainly helps that they have, in what my opinion, no doubt about it, the best catcher in baseball, William Contreras. An opposite field home run in the rain today. He continues to tear the cover off the ball. It's an 8-game hitting streak now for William. He's been phenomenal. As I keep talking about the offense here before I get to Freddie, I do want to talk a lot more about Freddie a little bit later on in the program. But the offense today, aside from Jackson Churio, everybody got in on the act. And of course, it was the Jackson versus Jackson show, and both those guys went 0-for. Jackson going 0-for-6 with three punchouts, but then William 1-for-4 with the home run and a walk, no strikeouts. Yelly gets pulled. Perkins even gets a knock. They both got knocks in the three spot. Willy Adames had a great day, triple shy of the cycle, 3-for-5, three runs batted in. Frelick 2-for-4. He also drove in a run and had a walk. And once again, six total strikeouts for the offense and four walks. Gosh, I am just in love with this offense. 855-616-1620. Let's get to the phone lines now. Colin in Delafield, you're live here on Brewers Extra Innings.
Hey, how's it going, Brother Dom?
Hey there, how you doing?
Good. Hey, look, this is impressive. I'll go back to spring training, and it just felt like we needed more arms. Like, you know, the young guys may or may not produce, but ultimately we need more arms. But, I mean, here we are. We're scoring like 6, 7, 8, 9 runs a game. I mean, really, this is not sustainable. I mean, do you think that we need some more arms going forward? I mean, we're going to hit some ebbs and flows with these young guys, I would think. You know, right? So, I mean, it's just, like, what do we need going forward here?
You'll never say no to more arms, right? I mean, no team ever has enough depth at the pitching position. And when you think about the Brewers, Trevor McGill's on his way back, and he will be going down to Nashville for probably just one, maybe two appearances. Devin Williams will reemerge come All-Star break. That will be huge for the bullpen because it lets everything kind of go back an inning. You imagine D.L. Hall will get better. If Freddie keeps looking like this, Freddie, you're not going to turn down more pitching, but it's hard to think that the offense is going to need much. Now, injuries are always going to pop up, and we're all holding our breath on Yelly right now. But you're right. It's not sustainable. I'm going to enjoy it while it lasts and ride and hang on with both hands as tight as I can, but we're 12 games into the year. There's going to be a stretch where they look like they can't score a run. And there's going to be a stretch where it's like last year where in June when they hit rock bottom, right, when they lost 5 in a row to the A's and to the Twins, and then they got back on track. So there is going to be ebb and flow. You're absolutely right, Colin. I appreciate the call. But, I mean, I'll never say no to pitching. Ever, ever, ever. I will never say no. Get more pitching. It is always something to keep an eye on. Appreciate it, Colin. If you want to join in, again, 855-616-1620, 855-616-1620. Take our first break of the evening. We got to talk about the pitching, though. We got to talk about Freddie Peralta. That's coming up next here on your home of the Brewers, 620 WTMJ.
Coming up, more Brewers Extra Innings on WTMJ.
To only breathe in but never breathe out is neither natural nor healthy. The same goes for the breath of life the Holy Spirit gives to the followers of Christ. Dr. Leo Sanchez tells how the Holy Spirit breathes life into the church so that the church can breathe that life out to the world with the love of Christ. This week on The Lutheran Hour.
The Lutheran Hour, Sunday mornings at 6:30 on WTMJ.
Don't pay retail for your diamond engagement ring or gift. Come to cleanorigin.com.
Amish outdoor furniture with poly and wood available. And that poly is the richest of outdoor furniture. It's just about indestructible and will virtually last forever. At Erickson's, we have poly furniture in abundance, so you're guaranteed to see a great selection. The beauty of it is you can put it outside all year round and not worry about it, because the color runs all the way through, so it doesn't fade. And minor nicks and scratches won't hurt the look. Erickson's Landscape Supply. For an abundant selection of poly and wood Amish outdoor furniture, visit ericksonslandscapesupply.com to see our entire selection. You'll be hard-pressed to find a better selection of metal yard art than we have here at Erickson's. Anything from natural and painted metal signs to painted roosters from 1 to 6 feet tall. Natural steel flying ducks and cattails. Cute little frogs, geckos, pigs, flamingos, and goats. And palm trees. The list is endless. And that's why you come here. Erickson's Landscape Supply, right on Spring Street in Union Grove, where you'll find a fantastic array of artisanal metal yard art. Visit ericksonslandscapesupply.com to see our entire selection. Or better yet, drive on over and take a gander at the goods.
This is Brewers Extra Innings on WTMJ.
Brewers win 11-1. We continue on with postgame. I'm Dominic Catronio. Of course, the offense was a big part of the story. We do got to talk about the pitching. Before we do that, I want to remind you that Brewers Extra Innings all season long is brought to you by Fifth Third Bank. With a local Milwaukee team, Fifth Third Bank also knows how to hit it out of the park. They've been serving businesses in the area for nearly 15 years, offering industry-specific expertise and local decision-making capabilities to help your business succeed. This is commercial banking value that only Fifth Third can deliver. Fifth Third Bank, National Association, member FDIC. We got to talk about Freddie. Holy cow. Freddie has been one of the best pitchers in baseball since the start of last July. And I got the numbers to back it up. First of all, Freddie's line tonight. 6 innings, 5 hits, 1 run it was earned on a homer. No walks. 11 strikeouts. 90 pitches. 60 of them strikes. 18 whiffs. He has hit a new level since the start of last July. In fact, here are the numbers to back that up. Freddie Peralta, since the start of July 1, 2023, he has 139 strikeouts in 96 and two-thirds innings. Quick math in your head, that's nearly 13 strikeouts per 9 innings that leads baseball in that time frame. Furthermore, he only has 21 walks during that time. 21 walks in 96 and two-thirds innings to go with 139 strikeouts. Know what that K-to-walk ratio is? 6.62. That is sixth best in baseball. And again, everybody behind him, or everybody that has a better ratio than him, has fewer strikeouts than him. His ERA, fantastic. In fact, his ERA is right there near an old friend, Corbin Burns. His ERA sits at 2.89. Burns, since July 1, is 2.59. So 0.3 of a run difference. Freddie's been one of the best pitchers in baseball. And today it moves to 9-3 in that time span. And if you want to go just by how the team has done in these games, he's pitching like a flat-out ace. And the fastball just has so much ride. He's hitting 97 with consistency. He is taking that extra step. The Brewers are 3-0 this season in games that he starts, just like an ace normally would do. And when you exclude the shortened on-purpose start against the Marlins last season, so 13 starts, the Brewers went 10-3 last year when he was on the mound. So add it all up. And let's just go ahead and throw that one loss in there, too, against the Marlins, right? When you add it all up, 13-4 over his last 17 starts, the Brewers are 13-4 when Freddie takes the mound. That sounds pretty ace. That sounds like a number one to me. I was having this conversation with a friend literally earlier today, talking about, hey, you know, who's pitching for the Brewers tonight? I said, oh, it's our number one, Freddie Peralta. And they're like, eh, is he really a one, Dom? And I said, you know what? He's acting like a one. And maybe the outside world sees him as like a 1.5 or a 2. But I think tonight, and again, I just gave you the numbers. He's a one. Tonight, against a playoff aspiration team. Another thing about all of this. Let me sidetrack here off of Freddie. The Brewers are off to a fantastic start at 9-3. Every single team they have faced came into the season with legitimate playoff aspirations. The Mets trying to get it together right now. And Kodai Senga's injury certainly impacts them. But the Mets 100% came in with playoff aspirations. They feel they can get a wild card. Then you come back home for the Twins. They won the Central last year. They're certainly in the mix. The Mariners, they think they can get a wild card, or even the West, given the way that the Astros have been playing. Then you've got the Reds. The Reds are right. I mean, this division is wide open. Now you got the Orioles. This is real. Like, these are real opponents, and they continue to play great fundamental baseball. And oh, by the way, scoring as many runs as they have. But Freddie Peralta, fantastic stuff. 18 whiffs. I mean, I said it early. He just looked like he had it in him, and wow. We're watching him take a quantum leap as well. Let me get to a few texts here. 855-616-1620, 855-616-1620. This one from the 414. We're almost at 414 day, by the way, on Sunday. Great show per usual. Thank you. You're a genius. No, I'm not. You called it with Gary Sanchez last night. How about Gary getting his first knock home run? That was a bomba. Longest home run of the year for the Brewers. 430-plus feet down a left field line at Camden Yards. This one from Doug. You were right about not giving up on Gary. Hey, blind squirrel, man. Every now and then I get one. He was right on cue, just needed an American League to warm up. Hey, familiar confines for sure for Gary Sanchez. With all that being said, we do got to talk about the fireworks of tonight. We got to talk about what went down with Willy Adames and James McCann. I was very confused. Just got word from the clubhouse. Kurt Hogue shared it on his Twitter that Willy wanted to make it clear that it was something that happened in the game. He wasn't going to go into specifics. And the line goes, yeah, I was walking up, he said something to me, and I responded. And then everybody went nuts. So he responded. And boy, did he ever. We'll break that down. We'll talk about everything that went down there. We'll talk a little bit more about down the box score, what the rest of the offense is doing right now. We'd love to hear from you as well. 855-616-1620. 855-616-1620. Right here on your home of the Brewers, 620 WTMJ.
This is Brewers Extra Innings.
All Brewers games are on sale now. Get your tickets for an action-packed 2024 Brewers season now. That's any game you want, any way you want. All season, featuring brand new giveaways, brand new theme nights and community nights. Can't miss ticket deals and all the season's best Brewers action. Make sure you're here for every moment. Check out the complete schedule and grab your seats now at brewers.com/tickets.
Each day, there's a sliver of time when you can almost breathe freely. And you feel better when you can. But you know that eventually that sliver of time closes, along with your nose. It puts a damper on your day every day. So you pop a pill or you take a spray to try to get that relief back. But it's always short-lived. And all the while, in your efforts to give yourself relief, you may be making your nasal breathing problems worse. I'm Dr. Madan Kandula. And a simple in-office procedure from Advent called balloon sinuplasty could be the fast and convenient answer to your breathing triangle problems. Advent has been a leader in this procedure, which can be hard to find elsewhere. It's simple, there's little to no downtime, and it really can be life-changing.
Go to AdventKnows.com to schedule your appointment, because Advent knows when you breathe well, you live better.
Breathe well with simple solutions. Breathe well with simple solutions. AdventKnows.com.
Results may vary.
I'm excited to be joined by my friend Jill Kreider. She is the president of Azura Memory Care and Assisted Living. Tell me kind of about the mission of Azura.
Our mission is to transform the culture of care, have a secure place, live a quality of life that maybe they don't have currently.
When I'm at an Azura facility, it feels like home.
Having team members that really care about people is number one.
Thank you for what you do for our community. Thank you for what you do for the people that live in the community.
Of course. Thank you for having me.
This is Brewers Extra Innings on WTMJ.
Welcome back. I'm Dominic Catronio. Fun one, 11-1 Brewers win, dominating the Baltimore Orioles. Would love to win the series tomorrow, given you got Corbin Burns lurking on Sunday. But it's going to be a tough task with Dean Kramer going tomorrow against D.L. Hall. Before we move any further in the program, also want to thank one of our newest sponsors for this season, They're back once again. Sider Heating, Plumbing, and Electrical is back for another season with us, supporting us here on Brewers Extra Innings. Summer, of course, right around the corner. Man, it's going to be beautiful tomorrow. Now through June 15th, Sider Heating, Plumbing, and Electrical is offering $1,500 off Central Air Systems. You can schedule an appointment today at Sider, Sider.com. Sider Heating, Plumbing, and Electrical. Let's start breaking down what happened with Willie here. Context. Left field at Camden Yards, if you've been living under the rock the last couple of years, they moved the fences back, and comically back, like 30 feet back in left field, where you can hit a ball 396 feet like Willie did in the third inning, and it's a double. But that's baseball. And it was raining, it was whatever. But he popped one. He thought he got it, he didn't get it. Turns out to be a double. Next AB pops one, gets it into the first row, gets a home run. In fact, the double would have been a home run in all 29 other ballparks, according to Statcast, except for Camden Yards. But he got one. It's all good. No big deal. Remember, he had one robbed in Cincinnati by Stuart Fairchild on, what was that, Tuesday night. So it's like, this could be one heck of a road trip for Willie, but he's had some bad luck go his way. But anyway. So he pops one. He gets the home run. Brewers are in control. It's 7-1. And then later they add on. They make it 9-1. And Willie's coming back up to the plate. And all of a sudden, before he actually makes it to the box, this is in the sixth inning, there's a brouhaha. Here's what it sounded like here on the radio.
We've got some conversation going on between Willie Adames and James McCann. And now the benches have cleared. As Willie Adames came to the plate, he and James McCann having words, and the benches cleared. Umpire's quick to get in the middle of it, and Willie is fired up right now. Pat Murphy standing there, making sure nothing happens. The bullpen's on their way in. Nobody likes it when they're getting beat like the Brewers are beating the Orioles tonight, and frustration boiling over probably for McCann behind the plate. And he probably said something that Willie didn't like as he came to the plate.
That's what it sounded like, and that's literally all it was. You know, no fisticuffs, nothing, no shoving or anything like that. But all of a sudden you see these guys face to face and you're like, what's going on? Willie then got the last laugh. He worked out an infield single on a ground ball to the deep six hole. With Sal Frelick up, a wild pitch moved him to second base. Then Sal pulled a single into right field, and Willie's coming around third. And I tweeted this video on my Twitter, @Dom_Catronio. Coming around third hard. All right, he's trying to score. He's not going to try to clock McCann. He's not going to do anything dirty. And I called it the equivalent of dunking on somebody, but for baseball. He slides in perfectly. The throw was laid. McCann bobbled it anyway. Pop-up slide, stares him down. Then just goes back to the dugout. That's it. Message sent. You're going to get my face. I'm going to score on you, add to the scoreboard, and go back to the dugout. Winning. Winning's the best way to shut anybody up. And the Orioles are too good for this. I'm really shocked by this. James McCann, I'm sure, is very embarrassed. I don't want to double down on him. Willie Adames said he wanted to keep it between him and McCann about the specifics of what happened, but he just responded, and everyone was on high alert from there in. But James, dude, at the time you were down 9-1. If there's a time, I know you're probably not going to play the rest of the weekend, given Adley played all three games against Boston, giving him a commanded day off, and Adley's going to catch tomorrow, and Adley's going to catch on Sunday. Dude, don't. Just keep it to yourself. Just, it looks bad. And he's a veteran. He should know better than this. And let me go on a deeper rant here. Let me get to a few texts here, too, once I get through this rant. Remember with the whole Rhys Hoskins stuff from opening weekend in New York, and we get the win, we got the James McCann, and we got John Boy lip-reading everybody, and I love that for baseball. Drama, excitement, a little bit of reality TV to it. There's nothing wrong with that. Nobody's getting hurt. No one's getting thrown at, well, unless you're Johan Ramirez, who, oh, by the way, Johan Ramirez was claimed off waivers by the Orioles. How funny would it be if he pops up this weekend? Anyway, but this is okay. But what I don't want to have happen is guys get muzzled, and when they're mad, and like, look, should James McCann have gotten to Willy Adames' face? Absolutely not. But this is now going to be a talking point, something to remember, something to be a rallying cry for. And Willie got to have the last laugh and got to have the entertainment, got to have the stare down moment. That's awesome. That's cool. Think about Giannis mean mugging and dunking on somebody. That's cool. Jordan Love dropping a dime, doing a celebration, staring down. That's cool. Baseball finally doing something cool. Enjoy it. Let it happen. It's okay. Not everything is sacred. Put a smile on your face. If you're an Oriole fan, you're like, no. Wah! Like Rhys Hoskins. But anyway, I was shocked that James McCann, a veteran, would do something like that in a 9-1 ball game. And in case you're wondering, no relation to Brian McCann. Carlos Gomez in Atlanta, taking his time around the bases. Freddie Freeman yelling at him. McCann yelling at him. No relation, but that was making its rounds on social media this evening, but that brought a smile to my face as well. A couple of texts here. Adam in Gainesville, Florida. Willy Adames' swing was identical with every hit. One would have been a homer in every park except Baltimore. Then he gets a homer. What do you think Adames was seeing to hit the O's so well tonight? He looked like a sniper. He's been on time. I mean, we saw him, like I said, the one that was robbed by Fairchild in Cincinnati, that was to the opposite field. His first homer of the year against Seattle last Friday, opposite field. Obviously pulled a home run as well over the weekend. He's up to 3 homers now on the year. Sometimes it takes a week or two for some guys to get going and feel like it's locking in. And for a guy like Kyle Wells, who's a strike thrower, that is his scouting report, throws too many strikes for his own good, doesn't get a lot of chase, gives up a lot of home runs, kind of get up there like, all right, I'm hunting a fastball, and Willie was ready for it. Like, looking at what Willie did today, for at least for his damage, I'm pulling up the StatCast feed right now for Willie here. Da-da-da-da, live radio. Okay. First ball he put in play, the fly out, the little pop out the shallow center was 94 off the bat, but he got a fastball. Then the double off the top of the wall was a hanging slider by Tyler Wall. That was hit 109 off the bat. Then the home run was a fastball at 106 off the bat. Then the infield single was another curveball, but this one from Jonathan Heasley. Same with the home run was Jonathan Heasley. Curveball, so different pitchers, but he's on time. He's on time on the fastball. If you're pulling fastballs, you're a little early. But when you're pulling a breaking ball like you did for the infield hit and like you did for the double, that means you're on time for the fastball. That's always been a key for Willy Adames in his time with the Brewers. This text coming in, bring on Corbin Burns. I don't think even he can stop the Brewers right now. This team is rolling. I cannot wait until Sunday. It's going to be fun. And we'll have a postgame show for you on Sunday as well. And I'll just get ahead of it now. Corbin Burns is a very good pitcher. Very good pitcher. It's okay one way or another. But, I mean, honestly, what a juxtaposition it could be on Sunday. I don't want to get... We have a pregame show tomorrow, and we don't have a pregame on Sunday, but we have postgame shows and everything. I don't want to get ahead of ourselves here, given there is still a game before Sunday. I'm like, what a juxtaposition of Corbin Burns, the power cutter, great sweeper, curveball, like, the total package. And then Colin Ray, the king of fastball command, the cut, the sink, the sweep, the dip, the dive, the dodge, like, what a difference in what that will be on Sunday. That'll be a whole lot of fun. But I was just loving what we saw from the offense tonight. Once again, just fantastic approach. Well hit balls all night long. When I look at the exit velo chart today, a lot of ball and glove on here. Like Gary Sanchez hit the hardest ball of the night, of course, on his home run. 111 off the bat. That's why he's here. Again, Willie's double was 109 off the bat. Rhys Hoskins hit a shot. That was 106 off the bat for a flyout. Willie's homer, 106. So the Brewers had 4 of the 5 hardest hit balls of the night and 5 of the top 8. And then you go further here. 1, 2, 3, 4. You go further here. They had 20 of the 24 hardest hit balls of the night. 20 of the 24. Helps to get a lot of whiffs from Freddie Peralta. Really, really, really impressive stuff from the offense tonight. But hey, it's just worth one win, and you move on, you flush it, and see what you can get out of it. take a breather. More to break down from this one. I want to get to an unsung hero from this game, and you may not be surprised by this. 855-616-1620, 855-616-1620 on your home of the Brewers, 620 WTMJ.
Coming up, more Brewers Extra Innings on WTMJ.
We find the best way to protect and uphold the reputation of our business is to hire good people and then take care of them. We really do love the people that work for us, and we care about what's in their best interest. And what that means to you is this. Who do you really want on your job? Someone who's maybe underpaid or doesn't feel appreciated? Might not have paid vacations or great work benefits? Our folks have all of these things and more. Vito and I make sure they feel appreciated because happy people do happy work. There's a culture we're building here at Semper Fi that brings respect back to a very hard job. And that's why we know that our crews are going to do the kind of work that you expect. This is Brad Youngbluth with Semper Fi Roofing and Exteriors, your local, veteran-owned and operated exterior remodeling company. For your new roof, siding, window and door installation, or masonry work, you can count on Semper Fi to keep you safe, warm, and dry.
We keep you safe, warm, and dry, Semper Fi.
Visit family-owned Ken Michaels Furniture and our in-store design centers where you'll still find beautiful, luxurious, heirloom-quality American-made furniture. Right now, save 30 to 35% store-wide and take advantage of our complimentary design services. Whether you're moving, renovating, or updating, our designers will help your vision become a reality. Visit Ken Michaels Furniture in Brookfield on Capitol Drive and in Greenfield on Highway 100 to save 30 to 35% store-wide today. Sleep better and save more with mattresses from Milwaukee Mattress and Ken Michaels Furniture. Handcrafted in our Milwaukee factory, our mattresses utilize natural materials like cotton cushioning, which dissipates body heat, Joma wool quilts for warm wintry nights and cool summer evenings, and natural latex providing superior conformability and pressure relief for aching joints. Stop in today at any Ken Michaels Furniture store and save up to 50% compared to national brands.
This is Brewers Extra Innings on WTMJ.
Welcome back. I'm Dom Catronio. Just listening to the audio from a moment ago, courtesy Kurt Hoag of the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel. Great follow on Twitter. Just search Kurt Hoag with two G's. About Christian Yelich and what he felt. And Yelich, in his own words, said he felt it running on Willie's pop-up in the first thing when he was rounding second because it was a windy night. He knew if it dropped, he could have scored. And it feels similar to what he's felt in the past. He's hoping he's catching it early, and you know, we'll see how he responds tomorrow, in his own words. And then he ended the conversation with, "This sucks, man." He knows. He knows. It's really, really disheartening when you're off to such a great start, pulling the ball with authority. Already had a hit tonight. And then you feel the back tighten up. Hopefully, again, this is catching it early. If he's feeling better tomorrow, I doubt he's going to be playing. But something to keep in mind for Sunday and into the week. Brewers' next off day, true off day, not a rainout, will be Thursday after the Padres series. Just wanted to get that update in here as well. Unsung hero from tonight's game. This is somebody that had not as much fanfare about him coming back to Baltimore. I saw D.L. Hall was speaking with reporters today. Joey Ortiz, man. Joey Ortiz quietly has had a great start to the season. And today, Pat Murphy loads the lineup with righties. Could have easily been a day to put Oliver Dunn back in the lineup. But Kyle Wells has reverse splits. Righties hit him pretty well, like we said, with that straight four-seam fastball and the fact that he throws too many strikes. And Joey Ortiz, 3-for-5, a triple, 2 runs batted in. He hasn't been playing super consistently. I imagine that's going to change here shortly. But he played in all 3 games in Cincinnati. He started 2 of the 3 games against Seattle. Now he's got a hit in 3 of his last 4. He's been solid, man. I mean, I know he had that rough game on Monday night in Cincinnati with a couple of throwing errors. But I really like what we see from him. I know we've talked a lot about D.L. Hall since that trade went through. I think a couple of things to remember about Ortiz, he's also got 6 years of control. And he's going to get better. He was always a great hitter, and he's added good weight, added good mass. He's still very, very young, too. He doesn't turn 26 until July. What a move. What a savvy move. I love what I've seen from him playing good third base, once again, a position. Again, he does not have a lot of experience at. He's confident anywhere. We talked to him about it in spring training. He is confident anywhere you put him on the infield, wherever he needs to play. And he was great. Back on the saddle. No big deal. He'll get games at second. He'll get games at short. Maybe if Willie needs a day, if Willie ever agrees to coming out of the lineup for a day, which he wants to play all 162. Don't lose sight of what Joey Ortiz has been doing. It's one other thing about all of this, and with kind of a plug and play, again, another different lineup. 12 games, 11 different lineups for the Brewers now. I wonder how long this is going to last as far as Pat Murphy continues to mix and match, and it'd probably be another new lineup tomorrow without Yelly in it. But the team is always ready to go. Gary Sanchez, and I know I called it, we talked about that, off to a cold start, barely getting in there, boom, pays off today. And then he might have to sit for a little bit. Maybe he'll get the day on Sunday, and William will be the DH, you know, the day game after the night game. I don't know. But, man, it's Pat Murphy's got these guys ready, man. And I said this after the opening weekend, and I'll say it again here. This team is taking the identity of its manager. And one of the first media sessions we had with Pat Murphy in spring training, we just kind of started talking a little bit about hitting philosophy and about, you know, hey, on paper, your offense looks pretty darn good. And look, now, could have anyone forecasted five straight games of seven or more runs against playoff caliber opponents? No, but it's nice to have. But I'm one thing that's just reigning true, especially with the numbers, is the belief in the next guy. And it's a cliche, and it's coach speak. I get it. Dom, you're drinking the Kool-Aid. It's easy to forget that in the big leagues. Really easy. Trust the man behind you. You're all big leaguers. The nine-hitter went 3-for-5. And I know Jackson was 0-for today, but they trust him to be in a leadoff spot. William had a great day. Willie obviously had a great day. Reese had a couple of hard-hit balls today, including the double in the gap. Trust the guy behind you, and that's why they're hitting over 375 with runners in scoring position. It's been incredible to watch how great they've been this season. I hope it sticks around. Now, league average with runners in scoring position is going to be somewhere in like the 280s, you would hope, at the end of the season. But to be 100 points better, 90 points better, I'm not going to complain about it. And I said it earlier in the show, I'll say it again. There will be a stretch where this team looks like it can't score a run. Don't overreact to that. Just like, we're going to enjoy this, but we're not going to expect this. It's not fair to say, yeah, give us 6 runs every night. Now, it helps that the pitching staff has been getting that. But there will be nights that they need 6 runs and they're not going to get it. Or there'll be nights that, you know, oh my gosh, we only need one. Freddie shoved. He went 8 innings. Only allowed 1 run. Give him a run. And they don't get it. That day will come. It's 162 for a reason. We're 12 games in. There's 150 games to go. Be patient. But enjoy it while it lasts. It's been a lot of fun. I'm going to effort some audio here for you. We're going to hear from Freddie Peralta here shortly. Want to get that loaded up here in just a little bit. Take a breather. We got an ID during this break as well. Brewers win 11-1 in Game 1 over the Orioles. Stay with us. Brewers Extra Innings on WTMJ.
Coming up, more Brewers Extra Innings on WTMJ.
You've probably heard about employee stock ownership plans before, but what separates Fifth Third Bank from others when it comes to these plans? A succession plan that benefits business owners and employees. Full and partial sales, second stage transactions, repurchase obligation financing, and seller note refinancing, ESOPs can offer tax advantages, increased liquidity, employee incentives, and overall diversification of net worth to help your company plan for the future. Fifth Third Bank, National Association, custom solutions built around your goals. Member FDIC.
quality heating.
Heat pumps have been the norm down south, but they're new up here. And I'm a big advocate for them. They're far more efficient than conventional AC systems and serve as a backup to your furnace, too. They don't use gas, and they're really efficient. And that's why the government basically pays for a big portion of these babies with rebates. So before you install a conventional AC system, ask the man in the red van about an Armstrong air heat pump.
You gotta see the man in the red van. Quality heating, quality heating.
Manufacturers can void a warranty if annual maintenance can't be proven. Having a preventive maintenance agreement on your HVAC system keeps your warranty in check, helps avoid nuisance calls and your system failing at inopportune times. You get 15% off parts and labor on repairs, no trip charges, discounted pricing for replacements, and priority service. This is Anthony Zanevsky with Quality Heating. See the man in the red van about a preventive maintenance agreement starting at only $25.50 per month.
Quality heating, quality heating.
This is Brewers Extra Innings on WTMJ.
Oh, this fired me up. Wow, that came out of nowhere. That was quite a rejoin at 10 o'clock in the morning.
We got about 15 minutes left in the program. I'm doing some live editing here on the radio because I want my thanks to Kurt Hogue sending some audio over to us, given no Adam McAlvey, no Sophia Minnert tonight, some of our colleagues that help us out with some audio. But this is some really good stuff from Freddie because, I mean, he ran away with the player of the game vote on my Twitter at Dom_Catronio. So just wanted to give him his shout out here as well. Text here on the line here, this one from Mike in Colorado. Remember, so many of last year's postgame shows were full of anxiety, doubt, and exasperation. Even the wins were frustrating. Not so this year. There will be wins that are frustrating, Mike. You've listened long enough to know that there will be games like this. Mama said there'd be days like this, right? That's what Mama said. Mama said. Give me 1 second here, and I'm just going to send off Freddie to my producer, Max Meyerson, to make sure that we get this on the air for you, because I love talking to Freddie Peralta. I think he's just such an awesome dude. Second of all, like I said, he's becoming a one. And when you're a one in the big leagues, and with the deal that he's already signed, Matt Arnold, David Stearns, you guys are, they're licking their chops right now. They knew this was coming all along. They knew he was going to be capable of this. And a reminder, I've said this over and over, go watch the video on YouTube that the Brewers put together, going back home to Mocha, on Freddie's hometown and what it means to him to be from the Dominican and be a pitcher in the big leagues and sign the deal that he signed. And some people like to think that, you throw a dollar amount in front of these guys and they'll sign it. It's more about the game for Freddie, man. The money's a perk. It's not about the money. Or like the line that Pat Murphy said earlier this year about Jackson Churio. I don't think he cares about money. I don't think he cares about being rich. I think he cares about winning. That's a bar, man. And I think Freddie is a great case of that too. And not to get ahead of ourselves here, because we've been doing that a little bit lately. Look ahead to next year. If Freddie keeps on this trajectory, you've got a top three rotation of Brandon Woodruff, Freddie Peralta, DL Hall, Jacob Mizrowski, Aaron Ashby, Joe Ross, if you want to bring him back for a year, Colin Ray, if you want to bring him back for a year, Carlos Rodriguez. I mean, it reminds me of the Danny Hurley audio from a couple of years ago at UConn, where it's like, you better get us now. Better get us now, because it's coming. The Brewers kind of feel that way this year. It's like, better get them now when the pitching's down, because it's coming. Rodriguez, Gasser, Mizorowski, Wesner, Wichrowski. The list goes on. They have such a great setup of pitching. With all that being said, let's hear from tonight's player of the game. Here's Freddie Peralta.
Freddie, that was a crowd that was really amped up, looking for any little crack to jump on and make some noise. How do you think you kind of quieted them down?
Man, I think I have all my pitches today working. You know, I have to give a lot of credit to Contreras. He got a great game behind the plate. And, you know, we were same page the whole night. We didn't change a thing, even when we get hit. So it was good. I was feeling really good.
How did the fastball set up the slider today?
Oh, the fastball was great, and that was the reason that the slider was working better, because I was locating the fastball. The localization of the fastball was pretty good. When I wanted, like, open in, it was setting up the slider, because they were trying to get the fast one, then the slider was doing the job, and probably was the pitch of the night for me.
That last at bat to Mullins, it was three fastballs, 93, 95, 98. So, a lot of guys reach back for their last pitch or some extra velocity, but you reach back from 93 to 98. Were you trying to get something extra on that?
I think people that know me since I was in the minors, like probably low A, high A, they all know that it's kind of how I am. It's natural on me. Most of the time, I don't try to do it. Sometimes, yes, as I try to throw a little harder, but I don't know, it just happened natural that sometimes I'm throwing 92 fast one, then the next one probably is 96, 97. But I don't really try. It's just natural on me. It just come out like that, and you know, I get a lot of questions sometimes about it. But it's something that I have, and something that I can really control.
You get some Wade fastballs in there too, like 88s, 89s. Like there's times where it's in the 80s.
Probably the changeup. Probably it was the changeup. I don't think
tonight, but sometimes.
Oh, before? Sometimes. Oh, yeah. 100%.
Look like Wade out there.
100%. I remember in 2022 it happens. I wasn't feeling great at one point, and I was getting a lot of outs, but I was throwing that 87, 88, sometime 92. Mm-hmm. But yeah, like you say, it's something that I cannot control. It's different.
How'd you think of Holiday? Obviously not the best night for him, but what was your approach with him? And obviously an exciting young kid.
He put some very good swings on me. I was able to strike him out, but I can tell that he's, you know, he has a lot of future in his front. He's gonna be a superstar. That's what I think. The way that he's swinging on the plate, you know, it just gonna take time for him to get what he's looking for. But I think he's on the way.
Do you think the start kind of swung for you, or the game really swung that Hayes at bat in the fourth? It's second and third, and he's ahead 2-0, and kind of were able to.
Yeah, in that moment, I just was thinking I had the lead, and I was thinking just to attack him and, you know, just give him my best, and, you know, thinking that he has to hit my best pitch, you know, and then after that, we made the adjustment.
They were great. That was, I think, the turning point of the game, and if we actually did the three most important plays of the game, that was my most important play of the game. Yeah, tying right at the plate, two outs, great right-handed hitter. Base hit would made it a one-run game, and he strikes him out. You're going to hear all that coming up next. We got highlights after an 11-1 Brewers win right here on WTMJ.
Coming up, more Brewers Extra Innings on WTMJ.
Wholesale mulch? No problem. We deliver to residential or wholesale accounts, and we can supply you with whatever volume of the highest quality mulch you need. Nobody around here has more mulch than Erickson's. We'll deliver you a one-yard pickup truck load all the way up to 100 yards in a walking floor trailer. And if you just need a little bit, swing by and we'll fill up a 5-gallon bucket or two. It's the best mulch you'll find. Erickson's Landscape Supply. High-quality mulch and stone for a whole lot less. Commercial or residential, visit ericsonslandscapesupply.com to see our entire selection. Our decorative stone is available by the handful for pickup, all the way up to 24-ton load deliveries. And our stone is superlative. We scour the countryside, countrywide, from Arizona to the Carolinas. We search pretty much the whole U.S. of A. to find you easily the best stone selection in southeastern Wisconsin. See a rainbow of decorative stone colors to match any exterior decor. Erickson's Landscape Supply. High-quality mulch and stone for a whole lot less. Commercial or residential, visit ericsonslandscapesupply.com to see our entire selection.
Sleep apnea is a serious condition.
And the worst part about it is, because it affects you while you're sleeping, you don't know what this condition is doing to you.
And it was scary because I found out that I was waking up 145 times an hour. 145 times. I was scared. I wasn't getting the sleep I needed.
And that's the thing. Someone like John wakes up after thinking he's slept all night, and he's been feeling run down for years, and finally finds out something really is wrong. This is why, for us, solving sleep apnea problems is so gratifying, because we really are changing lives.
I've had more energy. I'm getting better sleep. I've been told from my wife I don't snore. But honestly, it changed my life.
This is Dr. Madan Kandula. Solving your breathing triangle problems means a better quality of life. And you deserve that.
Go to AdventKnows.com to schedule your appointment. Because Advent knows when you breathe well, you live better. Results may vary.
The Mind Chef restaurant in Hartford and Oshkosh just lowered their dine-in Wednesday and Friday fish fry price to $4.99. Kids and grandkids, 5 and under, eat free from the kids menu. Sunday through Thursday, call and reserve mindchefrestaurant.com.
New residential, commercial, or multifamily construction? Call Quality Heating before you begin. Starting a new remodel? Pre-planning any new construction with a qualified HVAC design engineer assures your comfort will be at its maximum. Because the last thing you want your new project to be is uncomfortable. This is Anthony Zanowski with Quality Heating. From Sheboygan to Illinois, to Madison and all of greater southeastern Wisconsin, the man in the red van can give you a master plan.
Quality heating, quality heating.
Her bedroom and back was always warm, while the one in front was as cold as an igloo. She asked me what she should do, and I told her, Mary, zoning will solve your issue. At Quality Heating, the man in the red van knows how to even out your home's temperature and take care of humidity or lack thereof. Heck, you spend most of your life there. Why not maximize its comfort? This is Anthony Zanowski. Ask the man in the red van about zoned heating and cooling ideas for your home.
You gotta see the man in the red van. Quality heating, quality heating.
This is Brewers Extra Innings on WTMJ.
Ready for this?
Get up!
This?
Get up!
And this?
Get out of here! Gone!
Time for tonight's highlights.
Here's Dominic Catronio.
A game that was billed as the future. The Jacksons meeting up for the first time. Holiday versus Churio. Neither one of them are really a factor in this one. Orioles and Brewers, game one of a three-game series. It was Freddy Peralta going up against Kyle Wells, and the Brewers opened the scoring quickly in the second.
0-1 to Sanchez. Drilled down the left field line. Hooking fair and inside the pole, Gary Sanchez. With his first home run as a Brewer, it's his first hit as a member of the crew, and the Brewers out to a 2-0 lead.
That was after a Reese Hoskins double, and the inning would get better for the Brewers after an Andrew Monasterio walk. It was the reunion for Joey Ortiz and the Orioles fans. Well, the welcome was not really lasting.
There goes the runner. 2-2 pitch. Line down the right field line. That's a fair ball all the way into the corner for Ortiz. Extra bases. Monasterio around third. He's going to score. Ortiz not stopping at second. Here's the play at third. He's in there safely. Welcome back to Baltimore, Joey Ortiz. An RBI triple in the Brewers' lead at 3-0.
Lane Grindle on the call for both of those here on WTMJ. Reese Hoskins went at an RBI single in the third inning to score Willy Adames, who hit the farthest ball you can hit. That was not a home run, but nonetheless, he still came in to score. So now it's 4-1 at this moment, or 4-0 at this moment. Colton Cowser hit a home run in the bottom of the fourth inning. All of a sudden, you know, oh, cool, the Orioles are on the board. And now, you look ahead, the fourth inning, suddenly a two-out rally forms after a pair of strikeouts. Jordan Westberg singles. He steals second base. Then there's also a walk in there. Runners are on second and third, and a big chance now with Austin Hayes at the plate.
The red hitter kicks, 2-2 pitch. Tried to check, but he committed on a slider down and away, and he struck him out. Freddie strikes out three in the fourth inning. 8 punch-outs, and 2 men are left.
That was the most stressful inning of the night for Freddie because the offense would be there to support in the next inning. William Contreras led off with a walk. Blake Perkins hit a single. Runners on first and second. Willie made sure to get it over that big wall this time.
Here's the 1-0. High fly ball, deep left field. Hayes retreating at the track. Wall, bye-bye baseball. Willy Adames. Gonzalez makes it fly this time. A three-run shot, and the Brewers all over the Orioles. It's 7-1 Milwaukee.
Absolutely on fire. Fantastic stuff from what Willy Adames has been doing on this road trip. He has been huge for the crew. Some more highlights later on in this game as well. How about William Contreras getting in on the party?
Easley brings home the pitch. And Contreras, a fly ball out to right. Kowser's back at the track. At the wall! Gone! William Contreras flies one out of here. A two-run shot. It is 9-1 Brewers.
Lane once again on the call. But then two batters later, we had the brouhaha with Willy Adames and James McCann. Willy would end up hitting an infield single. Got to second on a wild pitch, and Sal was up.
Easley 3-2. Ground ball deep in the hole. And right side, it's going to scoot through and into right field. Adames around third. He's headed for home, and he slides in there safely. Frelick will go to second on the throw. He just pulled that ball through the right side. It got past Jackson Holliday and into right field, and the Brewers lead it 10-1.
They would add one more run later to make it 11, but the real story of the day, Freddy Peralta ending his outing in style.
0-2 to Mullins. Swing and a miss. He struck him out. Strikeout number 11 for Freddy. Got him with a fastball at 98 miles an hour to end the bottom of the sixth.
It would be the last pitch he threw on the night. He's 2-0. The Brewers are 3-0 in his starts as they win 11-1 in Game 1 of this series with the Orioles. What a night for the Brewers' offense. They've now scored at least 7 runs in 5 straight games for the first time since 2011. We'll wrap up the program after this on WTMJ.
Coming up, more Brewers Extra Innings on WTMJ.
Trust in your family's comfort at home with Sider Heating, Plumbing, and Electrical. They're the oldest family-owned HVAC company in Southeast Wisconsin. 4 generations of Siders and their highly trained technicians provide a one-stop shop for all home and business comfort needs, including an emergency service line that's always live and a 12-year parts and labor warranty on all Daikin products. Get peace of mind by scheduling maintenance today with Sider Heating and Air Conditioning. That's S-E-I-D-E-R, Sider.com.
The Original Botanas Restaurant. Delectable entrees, 50 top shelf tequilas, 20 different margarita flavors. Stop by for lunch or before or after the big game. The Original Botanas on 5th Street.
Casa es su casa. That's Botanas.
All Brewers games are on sale now. Get your tickets for an action-packed 2024 Brewers season now. That's any game you want, any way you want. All season, featuring brand new giveaways, brand new theme nights and community nights. Can't miss ticket deals and all the season's best Brewers action. Make sure you're here for every moment. Check out the complete schedule and grab your seats now at brewers.com/tickets.
Is it time to give your home a new look?
Absolutely.
Get personal care from Adair. Adair Floors and Remodeling has a design team ready to help with all flooring and remodeling needs, including tub-to-shower conversions. Want to create your dream kitchen, including cabinets? How about the rec room? Adair Floors and Remodeling has been family-run in Franklin for over 65 years. For floors and all home remodeling needs, get personal care from Adair. Adair Floors and Remodeling, South 27th Street in Franklin, and online at adairfloors.com.
I'll say it again. Our mission is to protect and uphold our reputation. And what that means is wherever we go, we make it better for those in need of our services and the great people we have working with us. Our reputation matters. It matters to us, and it should matter to you. We believe that operating with integrity will set us apart from our competitors, and that this attracts people to us that share these same values. I say this because I want you to know when you work with Semper Fi, character counts. It's why you can count on the industry's hands-down best lifetime workmanship warranty that now includes free annual inspections. And it's why we always have one project manager per job, which is absolutely not the industry standard. When you're paying for a brand new roof to go on what's likely the biggest investment you have, you want it done right, and you want to be able to count on the people doing it. This is Brad Youngluth with Semper Fi Roofing and Exteriors, your local, veteran-owned and operated exterior remodeling company.
We keep you safe, warm, and dry, Semper Fi.
This is Brewers Extra Innings on WTMJ.
All right, final segment. Get ready to wrap things up. Look ahead. Again, tomorrow, Dean Kramer for the Orioles against D.L. Hall. That'll be a fun matchup. And then Sunday, Colin Ray against Corbin Burns. Tomorrow, we're on the air at 2. I've got you covered for Brewers warm-up from 2 to 2:35. Network coverage takes over at 2:35 for a 3:10 Central Time first pitch from Camden Yards. Then on Sunday, no warm-up. We'll be starting at noon for our network pregame show for the On Deck show for a 12:35 Central Time first pitch coming up on Sunday. So again, 3:10 tomorrow and 12:35 on Sunday. And I've got you covered after both of those games for Brewers Extra Innings. And in case you miss any of these episodes, remember, Brewers All Access is the podcast feed. If you got friends who are trying to catch up, hey, just go to Brewers All Access. Tell them that's where to go. Brewers All Access, wherever you get your podcasts, we're everywhere. Also, our 620 WTMJ Brewers page as well. 620 WTMJ on YouTube has all of these shows live. And then I've got my own little deep dive stats side of things at Dom Brewers WTMJ on YouTube as well. Got a new video dropping next week there. So like, subscribe, you know the drill of what to do on YouTube. This was a fun one, and hopefully the rest of them are like this too, right? Let's begin the path to 159-3, shall we? It's still alive, mathematically. It's still alive. Brewers have won 3 in a row, and vibes are immaculate, as one would say. 11-1, the final tonight. Back tomorrow at 2 o'clock for a 3:10 first pitch right here on your home of the Brewers, 620 WTMJ. My thanks to our producer, Max Meyerson, also to Kurt Hoag for sending over some audio to us from Baltimore. I'm Dominic Catronio. Good night from downtown Milwaukee, and until next time, keep on swinging.
Quality heating. Heat pumps have been the norm down south, but they're new up here, and I'm a big advocate for them. They're far more